Hey, what's up? My name is Adam. In this video, I'm going to show you how I use Notion, how I created my own Notion Second Brain, and how you can get your own Notion Second Brain from our Notion Second Brain template. I'll show you step by step how to set it up, how to do everything. But first, I want to show you how I actually use it in my own setup, just as an example to show you why you should want your own. This is my Notion Second Brain setup. It's exactly how I actually use it for my own work and my own projects, different life goals that I have. So I just want to show you a quick walkthrough of what it looks like. I won't go into everything because there's quite a lot of things that I personally use it for, but this is an example of how I use a second brain to embed hubs and basically use hubs to organize all the important aspects of my life. So this hub is about my life goals, and for this month of December, I'm focusing on fitness and nutrition. I need to get better, quite honestly, about my regimens. So I've put together a hub of exercises and different goals that I have with respect to those two items. And the Notion Second Brain template organizes everything. So I've actually gone ahead and used the template that I'll show you in this video and have customized it to meet my needs. Here are a couple of different features like the to-do list, the calendar, and the progress tracking function that basically just syncs up with all of your tasks. Everything you just saw on the desktop translates directly to your phone. So you can see your calendar, you can see your to-do list, and the hubs the same exact way. So no matter what you're doing, you'll always have what you need at your fingertips. And I think that's really one of the big benefits of using a second brain. It's that no matter what you're doing, you know that you have access to your tasks, your important initiatives, and you can be very flexible. It's not a super rigid structure. It's something that can adapt with you and really mirrors the way that you interact with the world and the way that you set your goals, the way that you accomplish your projects. So in this video, I'm super excited to share how to actually go get the setup for this, how to get the Notion template, how to set up your second brain, and how to start embedding hubs and making it your own. So, without any further ado, let's just get into how to do that. To get started setting up your Notion Second Brain, you can click the link in the description of this video to go to the Gumroad page for the template. That's what you're looking at here. If you're not familiar with Gumroad, it's just a place where you can have digital products. So we put it on Gumroad, and you'll notice that there's an area in the top right corner of the Gumroad page that says, "Name a fair price, and I want this." From there, you'll be able to put $0 in, just type it in, and then click, "I want this." This will bring you to a page that is like a checkout area. So that's good. If you're on this step, you're doing the right thing. Then all you need to do is enter in your email, and that allows us to send you the template. So just put your email in and click get, and then you'll get an email that is a confirmation. You'll also open another window where you have content to access the template and instructions. So in this video, I'm going to explain everything that you need to know about actually setting it up, but just know that you don't technically need to watch this. So if you don't feel like it, you can go set it up yourself and the instructions are there, but you can also follow along with the video. So once you go to this page here, you can click Open My Template, and this page will open up. This is a view-only Notion workspace. So you'll be able to scroll around and see stuff and play around, but you'll notice that you're not actually able to edit or customize the template. So that's what the next step is about. The next step of the process to set it up is to actually duplicate this template and make it a part of your own Notion account. If you don't have a Notion account, you're going to need to make one for this next step. So go ahead and click the duplicate button in the top right corner of this page. And then a little like circle thingy will pop up and says that it's duplicating. Now, if you haven't logged into Notion and created an account yet, it'll bring you to a page that is saying log in. You can also create an account from here. You need to be logged into your Notion account before you click duplicate, or you won't be able to do it. So make sure you go ahead and get your Notion account squared away. And after that's done, make sure you go click duplicate on that view only workspace. And from there, you'll be able to edit. So if at this point you're able to edit, you'll be able to notice that whenever you open any of the hubs that are already listed in the template, you'll see a blank area inside. And if you click into it, you'll be able to embed links. And this is going to be really important for the next step. So if you're new to Notion, just know that it's kind of like a blank canvas and an infinite canvas where you can, you know, create blocks of things, whether it's databases, spreadsheets, to-do lists. And I've actually gone ahead and done all of that already for you. So that's the reason the template's great, is like you can just take the work that I already did and steal it and use it. But in general, it's a very configurable platform. So I'll show you what I mean by that, and in the sense that you can embed hubs directly into it. So the next step is to navigate to your email. And depending on when you get the template from Gumroad, you will receive multiple email invitations to get the hubs that accompany the template. So these hubs are resources, projects, ideas, archive, and areas. So there's 5 different hubs that you can put directly into the template, and they'll come from Kahana. So you'll see these emails that say Kahana invited you to the Second Brain template, and click that. Then you can click accept invitation, and it's a green button, so you can see that. And then when you click it, it'll bring you to this login to your account page if you haven't already logged in. So if you haven't logged in, you can go ahead and log in. Or if you haven't created an account before, you can also do that, and it's free to do that. So you can go ahead. In order to use the hubs within the Notion Second Brain template, you need to have a Kahana account and to get the hub. So we definitely recommend doing this. The next step is to essentially add the hubs into the Notion template. And I'll show you what I mean by that. When you're logged into your Kahana account and you click the accept invitation button, the hub will open up, and this hub is basically a template in and of itself. So it's already pre-formatted and it has some instructions about how to use it and how to duplicate it. So if you read the instructions, you'll be able to follow along and do it yourself, but I'll also show you in this video. So you click the shared with you section and disregard all the hubs that I have, but you click share with you, then fork, and from there you can, you know, watch this little spinner go for a bit while the hub duplicates, and from there it'll join your private hub section. So at that point, you've now acquired a hub that you can actually embed into Notion. After that, just do the same thing for all of the emails that you get. So there'll be 5 total. Just click accept invitation and then repeat the process of forking until you have all of them as part of your private hubs. In order to embed a hub, all you need to do is copy the URL of the hub itself and then paste it directly into the Notion page that you want it to be. So take the ideas hub, for example, and then embed it directly into the ideas hub space within the Notion workspace. And yeah, that's essentially how you embed a hub into the Notion Second Brain template. And it should unfurl and have all the information that you saw in Kahana. I just wanted to mention that there's also a starter guide that exists within the Notion template itself. You'll notice it in the top left corner when you first see the template. If you click it, it will include some more information and details that I'll explain right now. You can add more hubs, integrations with Google Calendar, and other things to your Second Brain as you build it out. And after you're done building out and customizing, you can feel free to delete the starter guide altogether and get rid of it because it's just cluttering your brain now. So feel free to go ahead and delete it once you feel like you're ready to go with your Notion Second Brain. And then yeah, that's pretty much it. This is where the fun begins. You can go ahead and start adding tasks, adding projects, adding information into your hubs, and literally using it to meet your needs, and it'll be sweet. So I'm super excited to see what you do with it. From here on out, you have your own Notion Second Brain, and you can adapt it to your needs, customize it, change titles, change colors, add images, do whatever you want. Use your imagination and be creative. The whole fun of it is really adapting a system to meet your needs. So whatever you're trying to accomplish, I sincerely hope that your Second Brain is a tool that makes it happen. And if you have any trouble setting up the template, if you run into any issues, or if I missed a step, please let me know in the comments and call it out, because it really helps everybody else if we know things that we can explain better. I want to make more videos that make it even easier to set up a second brain. Your feedback and your consideration goes a long way. And finally, if you like this video, go ahead and like it, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification to get notified when we drop more videos. We want to make a lot more cool content. And yeah, hope you have a good rest of your day. Bye.